Hello everyone, it's Linh. I have been documenting slice of life moments since I was in high school, and I'm so excited to show you how I make my nostalgic coming of age vlogs in Adobe Premiere Pro. In my storytelling, I like to appreciate and uplift the ordinary, from biking through your local neighborhood to making your morning cup of coffee. Anything can be part of a story if you have a clear creative direction. Today, I'll show you how you can use color grading to create a warm, cozy environment, shining a cinematic light on the mundane, everyday routine. Now, when faced with your options for color grading, where do you even begin? In Premiere Pro, I like to use the Lumetri color panel. It can be a little bit overwhelming at first glance, but before you know it, you'll have so much fun crafting the look of your videos. There's basic correction, creative, curves, color wheels and match, HSL secondary, and vignette. Before I even start to think about color grading, I like to gather examples from my favorite TV shows, movies, photos, videos, and design. After years of learning how to color grade, I still have a lot to learn, so I like to map out my creative vision by making these visual mood boards. For each project, it's always a good idea to gather inspiration. Becoming better at art means that you have to experience it alongside doing it. Plus, to develop your understanding of color theory, it's helpful to practice recreating the color and lighting from different references. And with practice, you'll find a palette and a style that feels like you. And when I'm practicing, one of Premiere Pro's coolest features is the ability to toggle on comparison view and use apply match to imitate the color and lighting of a video clip or still. First, drag in your raw footage, your unedited footage, and your reference frame. For example, I'm using this photo that I took on my digital camera and I edited it in Lightroom. And it has this film-like nostalgic feel that I'm going for. And by going under color wheels and match, you'll see an option for comparison view and apply match. Select comparison view and choose your reference clip and a frame from your footage. Then simply apply match from your reference to your unedited footage. While the outcome is not always perfect, the nice thing is that you can go see under the color wheels and look at how they were manipulated to understand what got you to that color composition. Overall, it's a great learning tool to see which colors work with one another and against each other. Now here is how I experiment with each of the features to create my signature color grading style. First, you need to assess the current state of your footage. Is the white balance, not in balance? Is it underexposed or overexposed? Basic correction lets you adjust that so you can return your clip to a neutral state. After basic correction, there's a creative tab. Here you can adjust the vibrance, the saturation. I like to turn up the vibrancy so it adds a little bit more of a punch. An increasing faded film adjusts your contrast, which can give your image a flatter look, which I like. Then, my favorite part of color grading are the curves. The RGB curves used to really intimidate me, and I avoided them for many years, but now I cannot imagine finishing a video without using them. I tend to only use the color curves, which is the red, green, and blue, and each of the curves start as a positive linear line. Towards the bottom are the shadows, the middle are the mid-tones, and as you get higher up, it's the highlights. Each line has a color pairing. Red is red and cyan, green is green and magenta, and blue is blue and yellow. And on either side of the line is a color, as depicted here. As you make points along the line and drag it towards one side or the other, you'll see that color fill up the space. For me, I like to start by plotting a dot right in the middle because it's easier to do my shadows and highlights. Then I anchor as many dots as necessary to create the look I like. It's important to understand which colors work with one another and which cancel each other out when you're using the curves. For instance, if your video is feeling a little bit too cool tone, you can go in on the red curve and the blue curve and adjust it towards red, yellow, adding warmth back into your footage. I tend to like my highlights to be cyan or yellow, which emulates some old film cameras. And for the shadows, I like pairing a contrasting color to the highlights. So in this frame, you can see how the highlights are cyan, and in the shadows, it's a little bit more red. Understanding which colors are complementary, analogous, contrasting can really up your color grading game. After the curves, I used the color wheels to make additional edits to the lighting and the color. If something feels off for only one clip in a timeline, I like to make edits here so I can keep the other settings more streamlined so it's easy to copy and paste and be made into a preset. And lastly, I use the HSL secondary, the sliders, to draw out or dim certain colors. For example, in this footage of me and my friends frolicking through a mountain, I thought that the foreground was perfect, but the background was a little bit too red magenta. So you can use the dropper tool, go in, select that area, and then selectively color correct so it looks a little bit more blue-green. And the HSL secondary can also help with your basic correction. For instance, if the sky or the grass is blown out in your landscape shot, you can go in and select the greens, the yellows, the blues, the cyans, and adjust the luminance and saturation to bring life back into your shot. And after color grading, I get to to play around with fonts, title sequences, and animations. One of my favorite features of Adobe Premiere Pro is the transcription and captioning features. Personally, I love watching things with captions. I can't think of a single thing I watch without subtitles. Not only is it accessible, but it can really add to your vlog's storytelling and engagement. In the text panel, you can nearly instantly transcribe your language audio in your timeline and automatically generate captions. Gone are the days of me hand typing every single sentence I say. You can also create a preset of your captioning style so you can use it again and again in each vlog. And in my current style, I'm obsessed with this shade of yellow. It tends to pop against every background, every video clip I have. And I have a lot of fun finding the right fonts for the theme of the video. I love experimenting with different typefaces from Adobe fonts, and here are a few of my favorites. And pro tip, to spice up your vlog and add a bit of personal flair, you can illustrate and add in your own animations. This was a huge part of my earlier style when I was starting out with vlogs, and it adds a handwritten, homey feel to your title sequences. I like using Adobe Fresco on my iPad, drawing my overlays, and then importing them into Premiere Pro. Combining multiple disciplines, aka making mixed media work, can add additional personality and storytelling to your vlogs. I hope you enjoyed my color grading tutorial in Adobe Premiere Pro, and that you are inspired to transform the ordinary with your creativity and storytelling. The most important part of the editing process is to have fun. Don't be afraid to try new things, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.